Being with you is sometimes like forgetting myself. I don't know where I'm coming from or where I'm going. I get lost or I lose myself. I become my own loss. My own lost cause. I'm here now, alone with me, and I spread and spread and spread like sourdough, growing, expanding, never demanding. It's so easy being with me. And then I complicate things. I leave the land of me on a journey to the sea. The ocean view, that view that includes you. And it's so great. We can touch the sky, kiss the ground. And suddenly, we're speaking of hand fasting and marriage, and oh, I can't keep up with myself. As I run away into your arms, all the comfort in the world so enticing, so beguiling, the warmth, the presence of what I've lost long ago, the sound of your voice, your enfolding arms, the love in your eyes and heart. Your care and concern. Your efforts to support. Your gestures to uphold. And I burn it all to keep myself warm. When we're apart, I burn it into coal, embers, fading sunlight. Chilling darkness, soot underfoot, no sign of desire, no call from the fire, and I wear the ashes. As a coat of ashes. To keep me warm when we're apart. It protects me. I don't feel, but as changes come again into our lives, an unspeakable horror, a terror, a sadness. This quarantine challenge that pulls apart, shedding tears of preconceived surrender. We are torn apart, and as the days, the weeks go by, I begin, like the earth in springtime, to regenerate, to discover my own warmth. The life force within me. And I'm grateful and I'm reminded how lucky I am to be alone, to be at home, to not have to care for another heart, to meet the needs of another, to cherish the self, to heal and find my path as the fog lifts and I am on the artist's way. A lonely walk. No. A walk best done alone.